Let's go. I wish they did like a previously on As Dusk Falls. This is what you did. Right, yeah, exactly, like Telltale games. But even, I think there's had to be some other games that do that too, that they're just episodics. It just makes sense to do that for an episode, like. When we first started this game, I completely missed that this girl was the daughter. I completely missed that. She's holding her breath. I'm a little bummed that Vince died. I don't think he needed to. I really wish he didn't die, because he did his best. The other thing he could have done is maybe. Is maybe send her with them, but that's the terrible dad thing to do, is to not give yourself up in a hostage situation, is like, take me, not my daughter. It made sense for us to go with them instead of her, because then maybe she had the possibility of being dead in the car crash.
Are you okay? I beat my record.
Good job. Minute 50. 12 years, so. Yeah, but what is that? 12, 12, no.
Hey, you forgot your goggles. Thanks.
Your new PB.
It's Zoe, right? You work at the deli on campus?
Stop.
Sorry, that's not me.
No, I recognize you. You make the best meatball subs.
Wait, why is that an outcome?
Other guy, he's so stingy with the marinara.
I don't work there anymore.
Oh, sorry.
She likes you, dude. What are you doing, man?
Look, that thing you were doing in the water. Can I ask what it's about? Holding your breath like that?
Man, you
Some
really...
Some people meditate. I sink to the bottom of a pool.
Dude, why are you poking?
One of these days, I'm gonna get to 2 minutes.
Wow, that sounds intense. Why do you do it?
Fucking sense of control, challenging myself. It's where I feel okay, none of your business. Sense of control. That's where I feel okay. I feel fucking challenging myself. I'm trying to be like David Blaine. That's what I'm trying to do. David Blaine is my father. I like the sense of control is a kind of nice answer as well. That makes sense if we kind of get her to shut up too. Challenging myself also works. That was the other choice I was gonna do.
Down there, the only person looking out for me is me. So I've got to step up and take control of myself.
Sounds kind of lonely.
Shut up! You don't know me,
Maybe
bitch.
I like it that way.
The fuck?
I should be getting home.
Oh my god!
I know we don't know each other.
Leave me alone.
But I kind of have a sense for when people need help. My mom got sick a few years ago. I was spending every night in the hospital with her, worrying whether she'd make it. And all my friends.
She probably wanted you to leave her alone too.
Homework. And boys.
Is that Jay? Yeah.
Until I realized there was always someone ready to listen.
Oh, good. I just saw someone handbag. I just take it. Just take it. I just take them anyways. No, the last thing I want is for her to turn around and then alert the guy, which then lets him know that I saw him.
Right. Maybe.
Just ask for me. My name's May. With a Y.
Got it.
What if she's seeing things? Get her pregnant. 14 years. Okay.
So, I talked to Mima.
What?
When you were changing the license plate, I called to check on her.
Why?
Did you tell her any?
No, I just wanted to hear her voice.
So we're going to Canada. Okay. Smart.
Are you sure you're up for this?
Huh?
Hiking over the border?
I hate hiking. But, hey, guess it's time to be flexible. I'm gonna be a wanted criminal now.
You're not a criminal. You're just helping a friend.
Did you watch the OJ trial?
The what?
OJ Simpson? All-American football player accused of murdering his wife because she's screwing some waiter?
Kind of a big deal.
I don't really watch TV.
Bro.
Huh.
Been living on the rock,
well,
Jay.
The point is, nobody's what they seem, you know? Like, what are we capable of? Are we all just killers waiting for our switches to get flipped?
Not all. We might be... Not all. I'm not a killer. I don't think Jay is a killer, to be honest. I think he would not want to. Unless he needed to. But even then, like, you look into his eyes, you're like, Jay's not a killer. He's not a killer. He's not a killer.
What about kindness? We're capable of that, right?
See? The world needs more people like you.
More on the manhunt for the Desert Dream Killers, who first robbed the Two Rock County Sheriff's house, then took shelter at a motel that turned into the scene of a...
Wait, was that you?
I thought we went over this.
I don't want to hear.
I do.
Describe
Jay Holt as an awkward, quiet high school dropout.
They say it like dropping out's a crime.
Holt also has an accomplice, 16-year-old Vanessa Dorland, who is assumed to be armed and dangerous.
What?
If you see either of these violent criminals, please call 911.
Wait. That means her dad ratted her out? So now she is considered a criminal. What does this first one say? We made the news, sorry you're involved. Did he say awkward? Awkward. It's all lies. I mean, it's not lies. It's kind of stupid to say what's. We made the news. Sorry you're involved. I'm sorry you're involved, maybe? Did he say awkward? We made the news. Sorry you're involved? That kind of feels like Jay. Like what Jay would say. Sorry you're involved.
I'm sorry you got pulled into all this.
I wasn't pulled. I chose. I need a minute, okay?
I think saying sorry is fine, and I get it. I get why she says she chose. I think she was aching for like some sort of adventure. I kind of wish it was like, I like the comic book vibe, but I kind of wish it was fully animated, like the whole thing, or like fully mocapped. They're gonna close off the fucking borders. Oh, shit. Have you seen this guy?
Shit.
Don't. Jay, what are you doing? Oh.
Okay, don't stress. We'll figure this out.
My name is Dean. Wait, it's only one cop. Can we just speed through?
Morning, you two.
Everything okay, officer?
Just running a sobriety checkpoint here, looking for any intoxicated drivers
coming
back from that Riverpalooza music
festival. Oh, we're chilling. Riverpalooza?
Were you there?
Nah,
no,
dude.
Sir. We're just passing through.
Can I ask where you're coming from?
Arizona, Salt Lake City. Salt Lake City, right? Yeah, that's where we were coming from, is Salt Lake City. Was it Salt Lake City? Yeah. We went to Utah. And then her dad followed us. We weren't in San Francisco. I don't want to say Arizona, because if we say Arizona, that's where the heist came from. That's where the heist was. And then he would probably, he'd be like, oh, you one of them Holt boys, huh?
We were in Salt Lake City.
We're on a field trip for our, with our church.
Vanessa, shut the
fuck. Which church is that?
Jesus Christ.
LDS? You know, the Book of Mormon?
Watch, he's gonna be Mormon.
Anyway, if I could just see your license and registration, you'll be on your way.
Oh my god. Sorry, they're in the mail. Check the glove box. San Fran's where Vince... Oh, right, okay. Sorry, I lost them. They're in the mail? Check the glove box. Fuck. Check the mail? I mean, they're in the mail, maybe? Maybe he'll let us off? Maybe he'll let us off? Let it do the breathalyzer.
They're still getting sent. I just went to the DMV.
Didn't they give you provisionals?
Oh, it's the DMV. What don't they screw up?
Hey, my mom works at the DMV.
Hey, your mom.
And you are so right.
All right, dude. That's what I'm saying, bro.
I can just run the plates.
Yeah, thanks, bro. Appreciate that, man. Just run the plates. Oh,
dispatch,
wait.
Need you to run some plates for me? Montana, 3, Papa, 2, 1, 5, 7, Tango.
Shit. He's gonna find out any second.
Where are we
again? Why can't you run it manually?
No, we're good.
We need to get out of
no,
here.
No, 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 hold on. Wait. Wait for the cop. Wait for the cop. Wait for the cop. He said something about manually. The system is down or something like that. Wait it out. I think we're good here. I don't think we need to peel out. Peel out is gonna make it worse. And if he gets caught, he gets caught too. I'm fine with that. I really don't care anymore. I'll throw Vanessa out of the car and take off. Just wait.
Look, I can explain.
Goddamn database is down again.
Damn right it is.
There's a sneak peek of Y2K for you.
Right.
All right. I'm gonna let you off with a warning.
Thanks.
Next time, bring your license along for the ride.
Thanks, bro. I appreciate
Hello,
you,
officer.
Man.
Go on. Get out of here.
Hell yes. Played it cool. I've only had like maybe one or two bad, actually no, two or three bad interactions with cops. Most of the other times I've usually been okay. No, maybe like four or five bad interactions with cops. Every other time it's been fine. But sure. That's where Steve and Red are.
Hey, Squirt. Good news. I took Zeus to the new vet today. She was very charming. Said I didn't look a day over 16. In dog years, that is.
Shit. I wonder if...
That makes Zeus and I the same age. Except he's better looking and allowed to sleep on the sofa.
I wonder if she knows that her mom cheated on the dad. She needs to know the truth, that her mom is a whore.
Anyway, if you still want to come over this weekend, I made the spare bed, so call me or I'll call you, whatever works.
At least the grandpa made it out alive. Can you imagine if she got out of that situation, went into foster care, and lost all her family? That would suck. She's already dealing with trauma. She wouldn't even try to hold her breath underwater, she would just stay underwater.
Don't speak. Don't make a sound.
anxiety.
Where is the other bottle?
Damn. What you need to do is work on just strengthening your mind without the pills. Might take a little longer, but you'll get it. Search the bedside table, search the drawer. Is there one more? Probably in the drawer. Just might as well just search bedside table. Why is this? Yeah. What do we choose here? Sometimes I feel like.
Bottle. Am I just not seeing it?
Are you an idiot? Look in the drawer. There's an obvious drawer.
What is that?
Turn off the faucet. Search cupboard, search storage pack, turn off the faucet. It's annoying, isn't it? Turn on the light. Turn light on. Turn the light on. Is there more? No. Yeah, turn the light on. Really? Really? I don't feel like searching the apron is worth my time. So I'll just turn off the faucet. And then cupboard, I feel like, would be a good place for maybe checking for her medicine. We keep, like, ibuprofen and stuff in the cupboard sometimes, so. And, like, Advil and stuff, so maybe that would be where it could be. It was all a dream.
Jesus. Tell me I'm awake this time. Come on. Think. Where did you put them?
Alright. Check this drawer. In the medicine cabinet. Katie. Why would
Who's
you
there?
Get your gun. Get your gun. Stay inside. Why would you go out and check the hallway? Your door is locked, so stay inside. That seemed stupid to check the hallway. You open the door and someone's there, then they can just grab the door, grab you. Get the strap. That's what I'm saying. That's what I thought she. I thought she was gonna pull out a gun. I thought she had a gun or something. I was like, oh, let's go. What? Lock. Did you lock the deadbolt? And then close the blinds to your window, so people can't see inside your freaking house.
Hey, Grandpa.
Zoe!
I know it's late, but I could use a friendly ear right now. Do you mind if I come over?
Oh, thing is, I've run into a little, situation here.
What kind of situation?
Mr. Walker!
I'll be there in 10.
Oh, it was in her apron the whole time or something?
It's like I told you, I can't have tenants damaging the building.
And I told you, I didn't damage a damn thing.
Mr. Walker, I really don't want to get into another argument.
Hey there, Zeusy, old boy.
Zeus!
Zoe, thank God you're here. Please tell this woman I have a right to the quiet enjoyment of my own home.
Quiet enjoyment? You vandalized your front door.
Okay, slow down.
What do you mean?
What happened?
Somebody broke in and stole my wallet.
No. You misplaced your wallet, and you broke your own front door.
Is there,
Zoe,
is there
someone
proof?
Was here. I saw him lurking in the shadows.
Oh. What did he look like? Did he hurt you? What else did he take? I mean, lurking in the shadows, he's really not going to be able to see much else, and he's an old dude. He's obviously didn't hurt. He would have said that. He would have said that he hurt him or something like that. There was something else that he took or something like that.
Did he take anything else?
Yes, my slippers.
Mm.
Oh, give me a break. Your grandfather wandered outside in his robe for the third time this month. When he realized he didn't have his keys, he broke the door to get back in.
That is not true. I wanted some air, so I took a walk, and I saw someone, and then the next thing I know, I'm arguing with Shelby here.
That's not even my name.
Oh no, we're looking signs of depression.
I know this is
painful, not depression.
But your grandfather is declining.
Some dementia.
He needs a nurse or an assisted living home.
Oh God,
or...
damn it! I don't need assisted anything.
We obviously have very different interpretations of what happened. Still. Somebody will have to pay for that door.
You. Insurance can pay? Just let him be. Yeah. Wait, why are you tripping out on a guy that is obviously hurting mentally? Like, he's obviously not all the way there. Why are you not more patient with him? Don't you have, like, apartment insurance or something like that? I ain't paying for shit. He's got to have like retirement or something.
Have some kind of insurance?
It's his front door. He broke it. Huh? He pays for it.
If she can die, I'm gonna let it happen. I don't really know.
Can you believe that woman? Assisted living.
Maybe it was Zeus that broke the door.
I don't need a nurse. Just someone to do the damn dishes. Don't tell Shelby. But I know I didn't break my door in because I keep a spare key under the mat.
You do? Isn't that kind of unsafe?
You want to hide something where no one will find it? Stick it right under their noses. How are you doing, kiddo? Anything new?
Well, why didn't he tell Shelby that?
Me? I'm fine.
Oh, you don't look fine. You look like you just got back from a war. How you been sleeping?
Having nightmares. Good if I take my meds. I'm gonna be honest, my grandpa, he's the only person that I have left in the world here, I guess. I'm gonna be honest, maybe he can relate. He's supposed to be there for me as a caretaker. He was the one that took care of me for so many years. Might as well be open. And if he doesn't care, then I'm not helping him out with his door.
Didn't have a bad night for months. Until the nightmares started creeping back. Now, I'm scared to fall asleep.
Oh, Zoe. You were doing better a few months ago. Did something set you back?
It doesn't matter.
That's a good question.
Seriously.
So, what else? You still enjoying work?
I got fired. Missed too many shifts.
That's a personal problem. What are you doing missing shifts? It's irresponsible.
You can imagine how that went down.
Like the Titanic, I expect. Well... maybe it's a blessing in disguise. You always talked about being an investigative journalist. Why didn't you go get a degree?
I don't know, Grandpa. I just want to wake up on a beach somewhere no one around, walk out into the ocean, and disappear under the waves.
No, you don't. Take it from someone who's been a pro at running away. Wherever you run, your problems run after you.
Hang on. Where's my tablet computery thing? Oh, no. Those bastards. I got that for my 74th.
Mind if I look around a little? Maybe. Wait, I can figure out who stole your stuff.
If someone broke into his apartment and the door is broken, then, like, that's a much bigger issue. There shouldn't be... Yeah, it's a broken door, TV stand, a shelf, dresser, sofa. Can we look at this door? How broken is this door?
Remind me, where were you when this guy broke in?
Just down the hall, I think. Sometimes I water those petunias on the shared windowsill.
I thought you said you were taking a walk?
Oh, I was. Or I was going to, anyway.
Okay. Didn't really get much else. It also kind of sounds a little suspicious, too. Shelf, TV stand, dresser, sofa. Check the shelf.
All books, medical books. Is this all from when you were a traveling salesman?
Salesman?
Yeah, you told me you used to... Wasn't that your job?
Kid, back then you could say I was a jack of all trades. I think the only real job I ever had was convincing people I was someone else.
Oh, there's his wallet. Okay, so we found his wallet. What else was he looking... We were looking for his tablet. Okay, so obviously no one broke in, so his wallet is there. Well, no, we found his wallet. That doesn't mean that someone didn't break into his house. Someone could still break into his house, but they just didn't grab his wallet.
So you're still going to the pool?
I spent so much time there, I'm growing fins. Hey, cool car. Was this yours?
Once upon a time.
Free leader?
Drove that puppy all around the country.
Why'd you get rid of it?
Oh, you know, couldn't afford the upkeep.
Low key though, a convertible actually would be really nice to have. Check the sofa. Yeah, check the sofa.
You know you've had the exact same couch my entire life?
Bought that thing back in 98, the week after, you know, when we came to St. Louis. And it just keeps getting comfier.
Grandpa.
Oh, there it is. Huh. Glad they didn't take that too. Not that it matters. All I know how to do with it is play solitaire.
Grandpa? Are you sure you didn't break the door yourself?
God. How can I be sure of something I can't remember?
Look, is there no way that he can move in with us or that we can move in?
Have you never gone into a room, forgotten why you came in?
That would be nice for security.
Have misplaced or lost something?
I mean,
you know I've lost plenty.
Where else is he gonna go?
I don't want to lose you too.
Shelby's right. It's getting worse. places, dates, the school I went to. It's like someone's slowly packing my memories into boxes and none of them have labels on. Can you imagine how that feels?
To say for me a relief, that's such a what a terrible thing to say to someone that's opening up about them losing memory. To fucking make it about yourself.
Sounds awful. I can't even begin to.
You must think I made this whole damn mess up.
No.
Actually, someone's been following me too, I think.
What?
Earlier at the pool. And then tonight at my apartment, I thought I saw someone. But I don't know if it's even real. I feel like we're both losing our minds.
Good God. Zoe, look. I know you went through hell as a kid, losing both your parents like that. And I know you sometimes think it drove you half crazy.
Don't go there, it has. Okay. Just know it has.
Seriously, you don't need to remind me.
I know I don't. But that's what I'm trying to say. I don't think you are crazy at all. Because if you were, how could we both be seeing the same thing?
It's true.
Grandpa?
Either we're both losing our marbles or...
Oh, there is something there.
Or what?
No. It's impossible.
At least the grandpa's like on our side and not making us feel like we're an idiot. Yeah, so that has to be Jay, right? So call grandpa over.
Hey, I see you.
Call your grandpa over. No, this is so stupid. Call your grandpa over to verify that he also sees this man. And fucking run out there by yourself. So stupid.
You're following me. What do you want?
Yeah, totally. Just run down a dark, rainy alleyway. Should have had Grandpa look out the window with you just to be like, hey, do you see this too? God.
It's okay. I'm here.
I was fine. I was fucking fine. And then one little trigger and bam, it all came roaring back again.
Oh, the two of us. Me trying to remember, you trying to forget.
I don't want to forget. I just want to not care. How do I do that?
Thank God Grandpa's still here.
How do I make the past leave me alone when she had to deal
with this by herself?
Everywhere I go.
I guess you just need to stand up and face it. Look it in the eye and see this thing for what it is. If the past talks to you, you listen.
She got something in the mail recently,
and when
though.
When it's done,
we haven't seen what she got in the
maybe
mail.
Maybe you'll be free.
Please write back by Jay. Okay, so this is again. This is it's from my perspective. I think Jay wouldn't be trying to traumatize her. I don't think. Would he want to get in contact? Yes, but I don't think he would like follow her around and make it spooky for her. I don't. It's just not in his character.
I wish I had another layer on.
It's gonna be beautiful once we get some altitude. What's the furthest you've ever hiked?
I did the Two Rocks of Two Rock once. Don't laugh, it was hard.
Come on, we got a lot of ground to cover. Tell you a secret? I've never left Arizona before.
Tell me when I'm not about to collapse. I promise I'll care.
Here.
The hike that Katie and Luna and I went on was really nice. Because nice, simple, down the cliff. The edge of a cliff right into the rocky shore, which was really nice. We had this, there was this one...
You'd be going a lot faster without
one part
me.
Where the waves would come
I'd be
up
going nowhere without
on
you.
These rocks, and it would come back down, and you would just hear this, like... And it was the waves like running against the rocks. It was such a soothing sound.
Teamwork.
I did get splashed. I went a little too far because I forgot what I was trying to do.
Well,
I was trying to test
wet.
The water to
my
see how cold it was.
Like I've been in double gym all week.
And it seemed like the water wasn't going to run up
bunny.
To me, and then
going
bam.
And going. How do you do it?
Like almost to my knees got soaked. Wasn't too bad though. Experience comes naturally. It just comes naturally, I guess. Just like you will later tonight. Oh, just kidding. Still a celibacy.
I don't think about it. Besides, it's not like I got a home to go back to.
You know what? I'm getting a second wind.
Come on, Vanessa. Oh, that's pretty. It reminds me of Red Dead.
My god. It's even more beautiful than I imagined.
Sometimes at home, around sunset, me and my mom used to walk out into the desert. And on a hot day, if there was enough haze, the sun would just bloom like a giant fireball on the horizon.
Was it better than this?
Just different company.
Hey, you're bleeding.
That time of the
Shit.
Month.
I didn't even feel this happen.
Oh.
Let me see.
Kiss it.
There. That's better.
I'm glad you know what you're doing.
You didn't even do anything. You
so,
just patted it.
How do we get over the border?
We're gonna have to swim.
Won't it be cold?
Freezing, probably. But it's good for you. Wakes you up.
It's Canada.
Way better than coffee.
What a dumb question.
Oh.
We were saying that this guy, Katie, looks like the guy from 13 Reasons Why.
Vanessa? Are you there?
And the
it's me.
Singer from Wallace.
It's Dad.
How the fuck did he find us?
Dad? What are you doing here?
Do you know? Do you have any idea?
In what world?
You run away with?
Does he?
His name's Jay.
Does how does he
I know
find
all
us?
About what happened in, to the motel, and honestly,
in
I
what
don't
world?
Care.
Vanessa,
this isn't right. How did he find us?
Yeah, dude.
If you know who he is,
he's got a tracker on her
or
something. Like fucking chipped her.
He killed cops, Vanessa.
I did not kill a cop.
He's going to death row.
I didn't.
You have no
idea. I did not kill
what
anybody.
You're talking about.
You're wrong about me. Who else is with you? Stay out of it. Stay out of it. Okay, so who else is with you? That's a waste of my time. You're wrong about me. I could stand up for myself for sure, or stay out of it and let Vanessa, because this is kind of between her and him. But I could. I didn't kill anybody. Did I hold hostage? Yes. But I never killed anybody. I don't think I killed anybody. I didn't. I really didn't.
I didn't do any of that. They got the story wrong.
Look, I don't even care. I just want my daughter back.
Why don't you?
It's never happening, Dad. That part of my life is over.
Just accept. Oh, I knew it.
She's not gonna turn on him. We stick with plan A.
How did they?
Jay Holt, you are under arrest on the authority of the FBI.
Fuck, dude.
I'll admit, you nearly gave us a slip. That ranger at the entry kiosk earned his paycheck today. Now I got a whole team of federal agents here, so this is where it ends, Jay.
Aw, dude.
I'm not letting you people send me to die. Have a clear shot on
the suspect. No. I need her to just relax and don't take a bullet for me. Bro, dude, what? With her right next to me? Are you stupid? That is dumb. Dude, that's the most irresponsible thing for these agents to do, is to shoot at him while an innocent bystander is with him.
Let's go, let's go!
We're gonna jump into the river or something. You better go.
Come on.
Oh god. We got no traction on them shoes. No. Shit. Come on.
Wait, in here.
The dad has a gun too. Oh, that's right, he's a private investigator. Forgot about that. Can't you see we're in love, dude? Let us be. But there's no way there's no way we're outrunning that ghetto bird. Hide under there. Hide under
there. What do we do now?
Oh, wait, actually, no. Jump.
Past the lake. We gotta jump.
Off this?
Vanessa! Wait!
Stay back, Dad.
You jump, you die. You'll never make it.
We might. You don't know.
Vanessa, whatever you think about me.
Shit, did we jump or?
You were my little girl once.
I'm still your little girl.
Slept on my chest. Walked on my feet.
When is the last time you said you love me? I'll give you a clue. It was never.
Dang.
I'm bad at saying it. I'm bad at a lot.
You're bad at showing it too.
After your mom died, I didn't know how to. I'd say left, you kids would go right. The more I tried, the more you both hated me.
Debbie.
And then that went off the rails, and I know you think I'm a monster. But I do love you, Vanessa.
If you say we can survive this, then I believe you. But let's just do it before I change my mind.
Fuck yeah. Jump without her, jump together. Oh, let's jump together. We're already here, right? Is there any other hidden option? No. Okay, yeah, so fucking jump together. Let's go. Yeah, if we die, we die. If we survive, we survive. It's romantic. Can we kiss before we jump?
All right then. On three. One. Two.
Wait. Dad?
Yeah, honey?
Jump with us.
Tell Mima there's an extra pack of cigarettes under the sink.
No. Vanessa, don't! No!
Did they just belly flop? It didn't seem like they jumped out far enough, to be honest. we haven't even gotten to Paul. Good luck today, kiddo. Thank you.
You sure this is the spot? It's not on the trail map.
I'm good. Thank you.
14 years later. 14 years later. Oh, right. Okay, Jesus. I don't know why I thought they were at the same. So maybe, maybe they didn't make it. And this is like, is this like a... Wait, no, because Jay's writing to her.
Whoa, easy.
Or Jay wrote to her, right? There's... Hell yeah, let's go, Jay! Jay survive, let's go.
Don't speak. Don't make a sound.
My god. Zoe.
So Jay was Jay was good to us. I'm not mad at him.
I wasn't even sure you got the letters.
He protected us in the motel.
Ever since March.
He protected us.
You know you're still wanted by the FBI, right?
How'd you even find me?
The post office. I had your P.O. box number, and they helped me with the rest.
But if they knew where he was, why didn't they send the FBI?
People are nice here.
Yeah. They are.
Is this Canada?
You look so different. I knew you'd grown up, but in my mind, you're still that scared little kid.
You look the same. You've changed too. I mean, he definitely has changed too. He has longer hair. Still has that very sad look on his face, though.
You look older, too. More than I expected.
Well, 14 years outside will do that to you. Hey, come sit down. I got a chair on the patio. And I promise, you won't need that pepper spray.
Dang, he knows. Yeah, why would we even bring out the pepper spray? I don't get that, because Jay to write us letters, I feel like... I don't know. I would trust him. I trust him. He just wanted to be outdoors, and he didn't even want to be there. He saved us at the motel. Did Vanessa die though?
Nice view.
Maybe Vanessa didn't make the jump.
I've seen it a lot. It's so strange that you're here. Thought about you and your family so much over the years.
So you said, in your letters. I tried not to think about yours. But I never had much luck at that.
They're not my family, though.
Oh.
Well, technically.
Is that girl still here? The one you ran away with?
No. No, she's gone.
What?
I have a lot of questions.
What happened to Vanessa?
About your life and...
Go for it. I don't have anywhere to be.
New scar. How's your family? What the fuck? Where's Vanessa? Where's Vanessa? Did she? Well, no, she's obviously there because there was J and B on the wood. Did she just get over the whole life thing, or like the whole wilderness thing? Did she get miss her family? They get in a fight about something.
Her name was Vanessa, right? Can I ask what happened?
Did she go crazy?
We spent 6 years together.
Nice.
Me and her slept outside when it was warm. Used to read books to each other by the fire.
6 years.
But in the end, I guess she missed normal life.
Interesting.
I think she's in California now.
That's where we all end up eventually.
I'm just grateful for the time we had.
That's actually kind of, you know what? I actually really like that. I like that. At least they spent a decent amount of time. How's your family? New scar? Have you, like, you ran into a tree or something? You ever been recognized? Obviously, how did you survive the jump? I think that's a good one. I don't know. I feel like it's kind of...
You know, the world thought you were dead after you jumped off that cliff.
We almost were. But I blacked out when I hit the water.
That impact, I bet.
Vanessa pulled me to shore. Spent weeks on foot after that.
He's probably so tired from running.
Had some lucky breaks with the weather, but we only made it because we had each other.
So if he jumped out alone... Oh, dang. So if he jumped by himself and he blacked out, he probably would have died. So it was good that we jumped with Vanessa. How's your family? This is stupid. Why would you ask this question? Like, obviously I don't think he's going to be in contact unless he writes to them, maybe? Yeah, let's do it. How's your family?
Do you ever hear from your family?
Nah. Ma left the country, I think.
Figured.
Don't know where. Tyler wasn't so lucky. He's on death row in Arizona.
That's where he deserves to be.
My pa and I sent letters a few times.
That's where he deserves to be.
But he said it was too dangerous for me. So that stopped too.
Nice.
And that's it. It's just good now.
I'm glad Tyler got I'm glad Tyler got caught up for all that. He was terrible, man. He forced Jay into that. He shot the lady in the motel. Completely manipulative, was gonna leave Jay, you know, to get caught, left Jay in the car to get caught. Like, just Tyler sucked. Terrible.
I don't remember you having a scar before.
Oh, I used to explore a lot in the early days. One time I came across a bear that I thought was hurt. Turns out she'd just had cubs. Lesson learned.
I don't really care if he's ever been recognized. No more small talk. No, I mean, it's there, right? Might as well just do it. This seems like it would be a really nice place to stay, though. Like, especially if you're a very woodsy person or self-sustaining, grow a nice garden.
In all these years, you've never been recognized?
I had some close calls in town. But you don't really know. You just feel people looking.
The best thing...
Now I don't go far.
You should grow your hair.
The market. That's about it.
No, you should grow your hair out, like, super long.
Why'd you come here?
Wear sunglasses.
You said you wanted to talk.
I said I wanted you to write. But you came. In person. Why?
Because I love you.
I keep seeing your face. And my dreams. Out on the streets.
And?
And I knew if I didn't come look you in the eye...
That you couldn't move on.
Thank you.
If you want to talk about it... I might understand better than most. And I'm good at listening.
I've been struggling. Yeah, there's no point in saying I'm doing fine. You can see right through that. I think he's probably the one that could probably empathize more than Grandpa, I think. Even though Grandpa could definitely, but he's not there all mentally. And she can't really share any of this with anybody else, so... Makes sense to kind of let it all out here.
That night, when you took me upstairs and the power went out. Do you remember?
Of course.
Remember?
I was just as scared as you.
You said, don't make a sound. And it's like, I've been holding my breath ever since. When all I really want to do is scream. And scream and never stop.
I was just trying to get you quiet. The cops were breaking in. I didn't want you to get hurt.
I know. I didn't say it made sense.
Don't forget the wound. What the two of us have in common? We both got dealt a shitty hand and spent the rest of our lives trying not to fold.
Perfect timing, Darth.
A lot of weight.
Fits the vibe. How you doing, dude? How is the rest of your Sunday? No, the woo would have been great for when they jumped off the cliff. If that was timed right, oh, that would have been so good. You go, woo!
Maybe in some ways.
Oh, we're doing good. Doing good, Darth. It's been nice.
Jay. Why?
Been a pretty,
why'd you start writing me?
Pretty good finale so far. Where the hell did you get that dog?
There's a lot I never got to talk about.
I know. But why me?
You said you see my face at night.
Oh, welcome in, Ward.
Sometimes I see yours too.
I should just move here, to be honest. I think we would be good for both of each other. We're both traumatized.
Move on.
Not even like romantically. I think it would just be good.
You must hate me. After everything my family did to you.
No, I don't hate Jay. Your family ruined. I don't hate you. I do not hate Jay. I don't. I think I hate the family, but you could tell Jay was not really there. He was forced because he felt like he needed to be a part of it, but he didn't want to be there. Where is the other girl, Vanessa? Oh, you didn't hear? They were together for 6 years, and then she just kind of got tired of living in the wilderness and wanted back to the normal life, and she moved to California.
Jay, I won't lie. Seeing you isn't easy. You were part of my parents' death. I've been afraid of this moment for a very long time, but
I thought she might have died, to be honest.
You also looked out for me that night. I can't pretend I don't remember that, too.
How can you be so forgiving?
What's the point of getting mad? Because you're kind, hate destroys us, I have support. Because you're kind, I think, you know what, yeah, I would like to lift up Jay because he has done nothing but be kind to almost everybody. No, actually to everybody. He has been really cool. The only time he did anything that was like kind of pushbacky was when he didn't let Vince out of the car. But even that, it was purely because he was scared of his family.
You're a hard person to feel angry at, Jay. Maybe in my nightmares. But in real life, you're just a guy.
Who did some terrible things.
Jay. Are you okay? I mean,
are you really okay?
Are you really okay?
I always told myself I got dragged into it. That my family was just pushing me around. But what if I'm wrong? What if it's who I am? Do you think I'm bad? Am I broken?
That's tough. No, you're. Am I broken? Who isn't broken, I guess, is a good. Who isn't broken? Yeah. Who isn't broken? I think it'd be stupid to say you're not broken, because I would kind of invalidate some feelings that he has. And I think it also. Like, we put ourselves in that too. We're broken as well. Like, it's just.
It might be. But who isn't broken? Just look at us. Anyone who pretends they're whole, they're full of shit.
It's a fucked up world, I guess.
It's a fucked up world. Oh, I should get back down to the bus stop.
No, stay here, dude. What the fuck?
That's probably a good idea.
This is stupid, dude. Stay.
Take care of yourself. Alright?
Sure. You too.
This is a perfect place, Zoe. What are you doing? I I think that was the best outcome that we could have had between the two of them. Obviously, she could have been really mad, but she got closure, which is good. Them.
You just learn to keep them behind you and look toward the light. Why are some of us able to grow and change, while others have their time on Earth cut short?
Vince was a good dad. It sucks what happened to him.
Why do some of us find ways to endure?
Hell yeah, Tyler. Eat shit. Is this the mom? She better be with Paul. That is the mom. What's she doing? Where's she at? She in fucking Mexico? Is that Paul? Paul, let's go!
While others just wither on the vine.
Paul made it to Mexico.
I don't know the answers.
But
I know I'm done running from shadows.
Is this the ending? Nobody's, I mean, we'll see. We've been playing this for about almost an hour and a half, so I don't know if there's a continuation, but I think it is the finale. Best end. Maybe. We don't know yet, Darth. We don't know.
Thinking about our conversation the other day, about facing up to things, and there's something I never told anyone.
Oh, what is Grandpa going to say
that
now?
That day in Two Rock, where I suggested we take the scenic route.
Oh, God.
There was a reason. I'd been there before.
That's right. Paul did say he recognized Grandpa.
Afterward, the Desert Dream, all of it.
Oh.
I think it was all my fault.
Is he the dad of... Is he the dad of...
Grandpa?
Oh shit, dude, what the fuck? Dude, what the fuck? There's no way that can be the ending. There's no way. That leaves way too many things unanswered. There has to be more. There has to be more. Unless the books are just not finished yet. If that is the ending, I would be really upset, because that it leaves way too much unanswered, and it starts a whole nother like trajectory that just doesn't go anywhere. Okay, so we got value. We value peace. Seeks calm, avoids confrontation. Trait, we're sincere. Seeks genuine connections with others. Playstyle, we have fast reflexes. Right. Okay. I think we did. I think I liked that we had a really good ending, or supposedly a good ending, with Jay and Zoe. I really enjoyed their conversation and their connection, because you can definitely tell that they were both very broken, right? And the fact that they were able to connect is, I think that was really good, because they were both essentially innocent in this situation, even though Jay was a part of the whole thing. It was obvious from the start that he just did not want to be there and was it was forced. So I think that's really good that they had that conversation. So we got a job at the deli. Do we think that Jay was running away? He figured out that was his dad? No, I mean his dad... Oh, well, I mean, I guess we never really know. No, that wasn't Jay. I don't think that was Jay who killed the grandpa. I think that's I don't think that was the case. I think the grandpa got into some other stuff in Two Rock years before, and something happened there. No, you don't have to shut up, Wired. It's just I don't think Jay, it would be in Jay's character. I thought maybe that could be a connection, but I don't think that would be a situation. Because we know Jay's mom was really like, was the mom in the story, Sharon, I think of name or whatever, wasn't really his mom. His mom was her sister. So we didn't know who the dad was. It'd be interesting to know who the actual dad was, but I don't think it would be Grandpa. So we beat our record. May knew Zoe from the deli. Voicemail from Jim. Another nightmare. We stayed inside. That's good. I wonder if we went outside, if we would have gotten shot or something like that. Because if Zoe was seeing that figure and so was Grandpa, maybe that guy was trying to get retaliation. Searched Jim's apartment. We found Jim's wallet. Saw a mysterious figure. Tracked an innocent pedestrian. Dang, there's a whole mess of things we didn't even get into over here. Sheesh. Sympathize with Jay. We couldn't comfort Jay. Oh no. Damn. We tried. We learned of Vanessa's fate. Visited Jay. Yeah. So Jay's fate. Jay remained in Canada. Yeah, so he's in Canada. That's great. Vince and Michelle's fate. Vince died. 17%. Michelle died. So there is a way for Michelle and Vince to survive in this. Okay. Tyler's fate. Tyler was arrested 50%. Okay. So either, I have a feeling Tyler could either die, he escapes, or he gets arrested. Sharon's fate. Sharon escaped country with Paul. So that's fine, I guess. I mean, at least Paul made it out. I guess the other one would be she dies. And gets caught. Let's see, Jay. Continue journey with Vanessa. Reach roadblock together. Reach the border patrol and not pursued. Convince cop. I forgot that we were. This is like takes place in like 89 or something like that. So it made sense why they were able to get away from the cop. Because they needed to call it in. He didn't have that, like, information in his cop car at that time, I think. Enter the national park. Tracked by the cops. Jay pursued by the cops. Fought off Mr. Dorland. We jumped from the falls with Vanessa. 47%. So we either could have left her up there alone or jumped with her. I think jumping with her was the best option. Because she was the one that pulled us out of the river, because he said that he blacked out, so she saved him. And they also got to spend 6 years together in the wilderness. Like, even if it didn't last forever, like, I think that's still really nice for Jay. Like, that seemed like he found someone, he was in his element, and was able to just enjoy that. So that's really cool. There's a whole mess of things we didn't see here. And yeah, if we didn't survive, then that means Zoe wouldn't have been able to visit Jay and get closure. Then she would have just been stuck with trauma, so that's kind of nice. GG. So that's the whole story. So we had Zoe. We had Zoe, Jay, Sharon, Paul, who I guess you could say survived, right? Tyler's in jail. Grandpa died. But I'm so confused as to why the grandpa died. Why did Grandpa get shot in As Dusk Falls?